One of the most annoying and frustrating things that can happen when it comes to technology is data loss. This can happen for many different reasons, and it's just as common on iPhones as it is on any other device. Alt Data is a tool which can help you recover lost data from your device and from previous backups. It allows you to find deleted files without the need to restore an entire backup onto your device, which would otherwise be the only solution. Alt Data can also help repair common iOS faults, such as being stuck in recovery mode, boot looping, and just things like that. Today we're going to be taking a look at Alt Data, showing you how it works, and just basically seeing what you can do with it. So I've got Alt Data installed on my Windows PC here, but it's also available for Mac OS as well. It allows you to just basically recover files from your device. So if we go and open it up here, the first thing we're going to see is my iPhone X, which is plugged into our device. You can see we've got four different tabs at the top of the window, which allow you to recover from your iOS device, recover from an iTunes backup file, recover from an iCloud backup file, and then you've got repair operating system as well, which we'll take a closer look at later. Since I've got my iPhone X plugged in here, as you can see, it's prompting me to select which kind of files I'm interested in recovering. For now, we're just going to select all of them and click on Start Scan, and that's going to basically just show us everything that is available. The scan can take a little while depending on how much data you have on your device. Obviously, if you have a lot of photos and a lot of other data, it might take quite a while. My main phone took about 20 minutes to scan through completely, but if you don't have much on your phone, like I do with this test phone here, then it'll go through pretty quick. Once the scan is complete, you can see we can see in the left-hand menu which kind of files are available to recover. So for example, we can see contacts, messages. None of those are available for this device since there's not actually anything on it. But as you can see, for example, we've got a note here that which has been recovered, which is just a repo for Cydia, for example. We've got our Safari browsing history we can look through, which is just sites that I've been on recently, just for various different reasons in other videos. We can see calendar appointments, which since this isn't the main phone, they're just standard holiday ones, but if you had other calendar appointments in here that you wanted to recover, they would show up there as well. Your reminders, FaceTime call data, photos is probably going to be the main one for most people. As you see, it's pretty much just screenshots on this device here, but if you had a photo that you accidentally deleted, or maybe you just don't have any more for whatever reason, just want to get it back quickly without restoring an entire backup onto your device, you can go in here and recover that. You can see app photos, app videos, voice memos, voicemail if you have some of those as well. You can see photo videos, you can see videos, music, all these different kind of file formats and everything that you've got here. And this main function of this iOS device recovery is for devices that maybe you don't have a backup for and that are damaged in some way. Maybe the screen is broken beyond being able to use the device and you want to be able to get some data off of that device. Obviously, it's not going to be able to get data directly from the device if it won't power on, such as if it's water damage or something. But if it's something like the screen just broken, then this is going to be really useful for recovering data from a device if you don't have a backup of it. The other alternative is recovering data from backups that you've previously taken of the device. So for example, if you have a backup in iTunes that's from ages ago, and you know that there's a photo in it that you really want to get that you haven't had on your device for a long time, you could use that backup to get that photo back. Same goes for iCloud backup files. They work in exactly the same way. As you can see, if we go into the iCloud or the iTunes backup file menu, we can see all of the different backup files that we have on our device. It'll go scan through them to see what you've got on your computer. So for example, I've got some really old ones in here which might have data in it that I don't even know that I've lost, or that I may, you know, not just have deleted a while ago, but maybe went back at some point. You never really know what kind of things you might find in here. Even if you're looking for something specific, you might find something different as well. So it works in the same way as the iPhone menu. You just click on whichever backup you want to do, and then just click on Start Scan. Again, the same goes. Bigger backups will obviously take longer to scan through. This one doesn't really have anything in it, so it took no time at all. The same goes for iCloud backup files. So if we go in this menu, we'll be prompted to log in with our iCloud account, which I'll just do now quickly. So if we just go ahead and log in here, as you can see, it's going to sign us in, and then it's going to show us all the different backups that are available on our iCloud account. As you can see, this is just a test account for me, so I've got two devices here with not a lot on them. But again, if we just tap on one of these, click on Next, we're prompted to select which kind of files we want to recover. I'm just going to click on Select All for this one, click on Next, and it'll go ahead and download the iCloud backup files to the computer you're doing this on, and then you'll be able to browse through them in exactly the same way as I showed you before. So once you've found the data that you want to actually recover, you obviously need to recover it somehow. So the way you do that is you just find whichever ones you want to recover. Let's just say I wanted to recover a few of these screenshots. I'm just going to click in, on some of them. I can drag and select them, or I can hold Control to select multiple ones. Let's say I want to recover all of these screenshots here. I just select which ones I want to recover, click on this green recover button in the top right, or the bottom right, sorry. and then it'll prompt you to select a data to actually restore that data to. So for example, I'm just going to save it at this folder on my hard drive. Just click on recover, and then it will open up that window with all of those photos that we just decided to save. As you can see, they're all in there, and we can go ahead and view them like so. Very, very simple. And that's basically how you recover data, and that's going to be very useful just for, you know, getting data off of your device, and then you can go ahead and put it back on if you want to do that, or you can just store it wherever you would like to store it. For other types of data, you can go ahead and print them instead. So for something like Safari browsing history, you might prefer to actually just save that out into like a text file or something. So let's just say we selected these history items that we wanted to recover. Then we could just click on recover, and then that will basically just put it into like a text kind of file. So if we go in here, as you can see, it's basically just an Excel spreadsheet. We could also print them if we decided to do that. So we can go ahead and print straight away, or we can preview the print by just clicking that. And as you can see, that'll just print those to a separate document that we could view on paper. Now, the main functionality of alt data is to recover data, but you can also use it to repair certain operating system faults that you might encounter on your device. This includes stuff as being stuck in recovery mode, maybe just being in a boot loop, maybe DFU mode, you know, if you don't know how to get out of it. Obviously, this isn't going to recover you from like hardware faults. So if your device isn't turning on because the battery is faulty or there's something wrong with the motherboard, this isn't going to solve that. Obviously, that's a hardware fault that needs to be repaired. But if it's a software issue, this is going to go ahead and try and solve that issue. And if it can't, it's going to go ahead and just walk you through the steps to restore your device to factory settings, which will hopefully just fix the issue outright since it will be a fresh install of iOS. So this is fairly simple how it works. You just click on fix. Fix now, it'll ask you to either download the latest IPSW file for your device, or you can go ahead and select it from on your computer. That's very, very simple. At this stage, it isn't going to go ahead and restore your device for anything. You're not going to lose any data just by doing this. There is an advanced mode which you can go into. So if you have any issues, you know, with this not working, you can go back out and it'll prompt you to use the advanced mode, which is going to go ahead and prompt you to restore your device to factory settings so that it is just a fresh install. And if your device still isn't repaired after that into usable state, then it is more than likely a hardware fault, which is the problem. So if you have any issues like it being stuck in recovery mode, it's recommended to go through into the repair operating system menu first, and then go ahead and try and recover some data from your iOS device using the first tab at the top there. Alt Data offers a free trial which you can use to see which kind of data you can recover from your specific device, and then if you decided you want to actually recover that data, then you can go ahead and purchase the full license, which is a 1-year license for $49.95, which, when we're talking about data loss, if it's something really, really important to you, isn't really a lot of money. So that's probably worth it depending on what kind of things you're trying to recover. And even if you don't have any specific devices that you need to recover data from at the moment, it's always useful to have this kind of tool handy so that you can use it in the future. And especially if you're someone who works in like an iPhone repair shop or something, this is definitely going to be something you're going to want to keep so that you can use it when customers come into you when wanting to recover data. So yeah, that's pretty much all there is to talk about with Alt Data. It's a very, very useful tool, which I definitely recommend you give it a try. And then if it's something you're interested in, get a license. I'd like to thank Tanisher for sponsoring this video. So they'll have their links to all of this in the video description if you want to check it out. And so yeah, that's pretty much it. Like the video if you liked it. Leave a comment if you have any questions. And as always, don't forget to subscribe.